A very warm welcome in the class of numerical methods. In this course, we are now in the module of solution of ordinary differential equations with the help of numerical techniques. Already those who are following these lectures sequentially, they know that we've gone through two methods. First one is Euler's method and second one is modified Euler's method in this particular section. Now we are going to check another method for solving ordinary differential equation in the domain of numerical techniques. So today in this lecture our topic of discussion is fourth order Runge-Kutta method. In abbreviation we are using as RK method or RK fourth order method. Now actually we have RK second order method also, but RK fourth order is having higher accuracy compared with RK second order, and that is why we have selected our topic of discussion restricted in fourth order only. So we are going to discuss directly the working rule for these types of problems, and the working rule for this is this is our problem basically, and y at x is equal to x0 is equal to y0, it is given. So here we are doing the calculation for y1 as y1 is equal to y0 plus k. What is this k? This k is nothing but 1 by 6 k1 plus 2 k2 plus 2 k3 plus k4. So immediately the question is, what are the things related to k1, k2, k3 and k4? We are going to give you the expression of k1, k2, k3, k4, but just if you see the coefficients of k1, k2, k3 and k4, they are 1, 2, 2, 1, and if you add them you will get 6, and you can see that their addition, that is k1, k2, k3, k4, they are multiplied with these quantities and then they are added and then they are divided by the summation of these coefficients, that is 6. So we are getting it as 1 by 6 into k1 plus k2 plus k3 plus k4. So we can think about it as an weighted average of k1, k2, k3 and k4. So in the remaining part we need to know the expressions of k1, k2, k3 and k4. K1 is h into f of x0, y0. So whenever the problem is given, either h will also be given or the number of steps will be given from which we can find out the value of h. So from the expression of k1, it is clear that we can easily find out k1 as h, fxy, x0 and y0 all are given to us. Now moving for k2, it is h into f of x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k1 by 2. Now look at this, without calculating k1 it is not possible for us to calculate K2 because K2 is depending on K1. Similarly, if we go for the expression of K3, it is x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k2 by 2. So it is also clear that until and unless we are able to calculate k2, it is not possible for us to calculate k3. And finally, for k4, the expression is h into f of x0 plus h comma y0 plus k3. So in the final case also the same thing is true. It is not possible for us to find out k4 until and unless the value of k3 is known to us. So now we are going to solve one problem using this RK fourth order method. The problem is solve dy dx is equal to x plus y, where y at x equal to 0 is equal to 1. We have to find out the solution for x equal to 0.1 and 0.2 by RK fourth order rule. So all of you can see that there are two problems. You have to find out the value of y at x equal to 0.1 as well as 0.2, though the value of h is not mentioned. But from this we can take h as 0.05 also. So to reach to 0.1 we have to perform two steps, and for reaching 0.2 from 0.1 we need to perform two steps. That means we have to calculate four steps. Similarly, we can take h equal to 0.1 also, so that we can reach to x equal to 0.1 directly by one step and then x equal to 0.2 directly by two steps. So as nothing is mentioned, we are now taking here h equal to 0.1. So x1 will be x0 plus h, that is 0 plus 0.1, that is 0.1, and we are doing it as y1 is equal to y0 plus k. Now to find k, we have to find out, look at this, to find k, we have to find out k1, k2, k3 and k4, and obviously we are going to apply the formula for k, which consists of k1, k2, k3, k4. We know the formula, that is the weighted average. Now we are now starting by k1. So k1 is equal to h into f of x0, y0. So what we can do here, 0.1 into fxy is x plus y, so it will be x0 plus y0. So it will be finally 0.1 into 0 plus 1, that is 1. So we are getting as 0.1 as the value of k1. According to the definition, we are going to now calculate k2. K2 is h into f of x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k1 by 2. So what we get, it is as 0.1 into x0 plus h by 2. X0 is 0, h by 2 is 0.1 by 2, that is 0.05. So x0 plus h by 2 is 0.05 comma y0 plus k1 by 2. Y0 is 1, k1 we got as 0.1, so 0.1 by 2, that is 0.05, So y0 plus k1 by 2 is 1 plus 0.05, that is 1.05. And we have the expression as x plus y. So here I can do it directly, that if these two values will be added and we get the result as 0.11 as the value of k2. Now our job is to calculate k3, and k3 is h into f of x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k2 by 2. Now in the similar manner, if we proceed, it will be 0.1 into x0 plus h by 2 will be 0.05 plus k2 by 2, k2 is 0.11. So if I divide it by 2 and then add it with 1, it will be 1.055. So finally we get 0.1105. And then the last thing for this particular purpose is k4, and k4 is h into f of x0 plus h comma y0 plus k3. So we can write it as 0.1 into x0 plus h, that is 0 plus 0.1. So simply it will be 0.1 plus y0 plus k3. Y0 is 1 and k3 is 0.1105. So it will be 1.1105. And multiplying it with 0.1, we get it as 0.12105. After successful calculation of k1, k2, k3, k4, we can now calculate k. K is 1 by 6 k1 plus 2k2 plus 2k3 plus k4. Now we can write all these values of k1, k2, k3, k4 and multiply it by the according numbers, we will get the result of k as 0.1103416. So what we get finally, y1 is equal to y0 plus k, that is 1 plus 0.1103416. So we get it as 1.1103416 as y1. Y1 means it is nothing but y at x equal to x1, that is y at x equal to x0 plus h, that is 0.1. So we have reached to the first answer of the given question, that to find out the value of y at x equal to 0.1. But for 0.2, we have to start it from the same part, that is y2 is equal to y at x equal to 0.2, and we can write x2 is equal to x1 plus h and y2 is equal to y1 plus k. This k is not the old one. This k will be calculated according to the new step of calculations. And for that, I am not going to show you the elaborate discussion. I am just going to give you the clue that k1 will be 0.12103416. K2 will be 0.13205111. K3 will be 0.1321138. K4 for this particular purpose will be 0.144298. Then sequentially we have to calculate K, and the K will be 0.132463, and then finally we will get the value of y2 It will be y1 plus k. Y1 is calculated in the previous slide. We get the answer as 1.242805. And both the results for y1 and y2, both the results we are getting from application of RK fourth order method for solving ordinary differential equations in numerical techniques. So I am requesting all of you, if you have your time, please go for the RK second order method, and you will get both the methods in these references, allowing you so many solved problems and also the exercise. Please solve the exercise problems, but as of now we have one problem for you for finding out the result using fourth order RK method for 1.1, and the requirement of accuracy is also given, that is, it we have to do for 4 decimal places. So y1 is equal to 1 is given. So here x0 is 1, y0 is 1, and we have to find out at 1.1, as well as h is 0.1 is given. That means it is a small problem, because in one step we will be able to find out the result of this particular problem. So finally, I want to thank you all. Happy listening, happy learning.